Okay. So thank you everybody for coming to this auspicious occasion. Today, my very first graduate student, Ahmed Rizwan, after 7 years of very hard work, is finally at a stage where we can give him the diploma, and he will be presenting his pre-synopsis on critical phenomena in anti-dissipative space-time. Go ahead, Rizwan.
Thank you, sir. Am I audible? Hello?
Yes.
Okay. So my presentation contains an introduction. Then I have included a list of papers and again a small introduction to the topic black hole thermodynamics and its van der Waals analogy. And some technical steps I have included at the end of the slides. So coming to the introduction, for in the past 2 years, it has been very fruitful for theoretical physics. And we have two major events. One is gravitational wave detection. Another is a black hole image we have obtained from the Event Horizon Telescope collaboration. And this was a first real test for the Sanger-Yau theory of gravitation proposed by Einstein in the strong gravity limit. And this has not only settled the very existence of black hole, but it also opens up a lot of observational window to the deep puzzles in physics. And as such, you know, like in two Nobel Prizes, 2020 and 2017 were awarded to black hole physics. Now coming to the topic of black hole thermodynamics, many features of black holes are both strange and normal. Like for in 1973, what Bekenstein proposed that like entropy of a black hole that increases with area rather than volume. It is a strange. Normally entropy increases with volume. And proceeding further, Hawking in 1975 proposed that black holes emit radiation with certain temperature proportional to the acceleration due to gravity. And that is nothing but the temperature is inversely proportional to the mass. Temperature is inversely proportional to mass. Mass is nothing but it's same as energy. So temperature is inversely proportional to the energy is again strange. Usually temperature is proportional to the whatever energy content of the system. Okay. What it means that when mass increases, temperature decreases, or when the black hole becomes smaller, it gets hotter and hotter. And these two relations, entropy proportional to area and temperature proportional to the gravity, surface gravity, we call it as Bekenstein-Hawking formula. Okay. And further, Bardeen, Carter, and Hawking in 1973 found that the quantities in the normal thermodynamics are have an analogous term in black holes. Like energy in the normal thermodynamics is mapped to the mass of the black hole. Temperature is mapped to the surface gravity or acceleration due to gravity. The entropy is nothing but it is related to the area of the black hole. Now, analogy with the normal thermodynamics. First, we have four laws in classical thermodynamics. The first zeroth law is a notion of equilibrium, that T remains constant in equilibrium. And first law deals with what we call conservation of energy, d equal to Tds minus Pdv. Third law is like entropy never decreases. Second law. Third law is nothing but T equal to zero is almost impossible to attain. So similar to that, there are four laws in black hole thermodynamics. First law tells zeroth law is nothing but the surface gravity is constant over horizon. And first law, like it is the differential of mass and how it is related to the area of horizon, angular momentum J and the charge of the black hole. Then second law is tells that area of event horizon never decreases. Then the third law, which tells that surface gravity equal to zero is almost impossible to attain. And from usual statistical physics, you know that these thermodynamics, whatever macroscopic thermodynamics you have, that is having an underlying statistical microstructure that is given by Boltzmann's relation, S is equal to KB ln omega. Omega is the number of microstates, so number of arrangements is possible in the microstructure. And as I told, strangely in black holes, the entropy is proportional to the area of the horizon. What it means that information content about the microstate is encoded on the horizon. So some information of the bulb of a system is encoded on the boundary, which is what is very familiar in holography, what is called holographic technique, where in the two-dimensional image you see a three-dimensional picture. Okay, this all makes black hole thermodynamics very interesting subject, and it requires all the techniques in physics like quantum theory, general relativity, and thermal physics to answer all these puzzles. Now, a study about this black hole thermodynamics has led to many profound concepts in theoretical physics, namely two concepts. Like one is holography, I have told, like something information about the black hole is encoded on the boundary. And second is what is called emergent gravity paradigm, which is proposed by Ted Jacobson and Padmanabhan. And what they proposed is that emergent gravity, what it tells that there is a effective degrees of freedom or effective picture of a gravity is a condensed matter system, and gravity emerges from something which is not gravitationally indeed. Okay, so that is the emergent gravity thing. I will come back to this in another slide. Okay. Now coming to the thermodynamics and thermodynamic stability, as I told, temperature of black hole is inversely proportional to mass. That and once you calculate the specific heat by specific heat, what we mean is that how much energy is required to increase the temperature of some substance by 1 degree Celsius. So once you calculate the specific heat of a black hole, you will find that it's negative. Negative specific heat means that substance get hotter as they lose energy. Okay, this is very unusual in normal thermodynamic system. So one way to have a stability to this is place them in a thermal bath in the Hawking temperature. And a natural box for putting this black hole is provided by Andy de Sitter space, which is Andy de Sitter space, which looks like a cylinder with the vertical axis is time and radial axis from the origin. Okay, so this ADS space emerges as a solution of Einstein's equation with a negative cosmological constant, and mathematically this ADS space is nothing but a hyperbolic space time. Okay, now if you keep the black hole normal black hole astrophysical black hole in a ADS space, then black holes will have positive specific heat and will be in a thermal equilibrium. Now another motivation by why we are behind ADS black hole is something called ADS CFT correspondence. ADS stands for Andy de Sitter space, and CFT stands for conformal field theory. This is a scale invariant field theory. It was proposed by Juan M. Malsena in 1997. What it tells is some gravity theory in the bulk is related to some condensed matter or conformal theory on the boundary. Technically, in string theory language, it is ADS 5 cross S 5 is mapped to SU and gauge theory on the boundary. So sometimes it is called gauge gravity duality. And what ADS CFT provides you is with a dictionary to find meaning of certain quantities in the gravity to that in its boundary, QFT. Okay? So this kind of a correspondence is used to study the physics of strongly condensed matter system using various gravity models, and vice versa. Gravity also studied by using some condensed matter models. One of the model is called holographic superconductor, where you study high TC superconductor using gravitational theory. But in recent times, what we have observed that this correspondence is much more general, and it is not anything particular about string theory as such. And what it is called in other fields of physics is called analog gravity. There are many condensed matter systems where its effective geometry is a curved space quantum field theory. Okay, so what it means that in the heart of gravitational theory there is a condensed matter system, and gravity emerged as a large enough energy scales. Okay, so even though there is no curved geometry to start with that initial microscopic description, gravity emerges at the macroscopic level. That what we mean as emergent gravity. So another examples what you will find is quantum Hall effects, whose effective theory can be described by Chern-Simons gravity. And this is proposed by Haldane, and Deepak sir was the one fellow, like one of the person who came with this model. Okay, this quantum Hall effect is effective theory is given by Chern-Simons gravity. Okay. So space-time or gravity emerge together from an underlying microscale theory, which is indeed a condensed matter system. So why it is important to study Andy-de Sitter space is that in Andy-de Sitter space, there is a formal way to study this kind of a correspondence between condensed matter system and gravity. And whatever black hole thermodynamics or holography are the direct outcomes of this emergent gravity paradigm. Now, what is our objective? The distinguished feature of this analogous system is what I told, like black holes will have some analogous condensed matter system, will provide one thing is more understanding about gravity, and another thing is vice versa. You can have a more information about condensed matter system. So what we utilize this kind of analogous analogy of black hole thermodynamics with van der Waals fluid to study the phase structure and critical phenomenon in Andy-de Sitter space, and different phenomena in normal van der Waals fluid like Joule-Thomson effect, heat engine is constructed for black holes, and the phase structure of van der Waals fluid is used to like interpret the phase, what are the phases in the black holes. Finally, some amount of time is spent for studying the thermodynamic geometry behind this phase transition. Okay. Now, some of the papers we have published during this time, like we have published six papers in some prestigious journals like Nuclear Physics B, then PRD, Annals of Physics, Physics Letters B, General Relativity and Gravity, and the International Journal of Modern Physics, and several others are under review. Now coming to the field of black hole thermodynamics, how we can begin. So in physics, like if you have a continuous symmetry, there is a conserved charge behind that. That is called the Noether's theorem. Okay. So if you have a J is the conserved current, then it will give you a conserved charge. Okay. In general relativity, symmetries in the space-times are generated by Killing vector field. It is much like cyclic coordinate in classical mechanics. And the conserved charge is given by either you can do is it's given by Comer integral, which is some advanced version of Gauss theorem. Q is equal to just integral of current. So this you can write. Then alpha, n, nu, sigma are something related to the normal vectors of the space time. Technical details I have included in the final slides. There we can see. So that important point about black hole is that there is something called Noether theorem, which tells that black holes can be completely characterized by three classical parameters: mass, electric charge, and angular momentum. So these three parameters can be written in terms of this Comer integral or Gauss theorem. So this can proceeding with this Comer integral, we can find the first law and relationship between the mass of the black hole with other thermodynamic variables in the of the black holes. So that is I have added at the end of the slides.
Can I just interrupt? Yes, Santosh yes. Sir, Partha, anybody, if you have questions, you please feel free to ask. I realize that this material is technical, but Rizwan has tried to make it comprehensible for most people. But if you want to ask, please ask. It doesn't matter how naive your question is.
I think I have just one basic question at the end, so I will ask at the end.
Okay. You can ask anytime, sure.
No.
So moving to SMAR formula and first law. Okay. So what we have it in mathematics is called Euler's homogeneous theorem. I can go to slide 62.
Rizwan, something has happened. The whole screen is not visible.
Not visible now.
I think something is cut off from your page or whatever you are showing. I think it's a PDF file.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, that's because it came out of full screen.
So. Okay, fine.
So something called Euler's homogeneous theorem, like if you have a function f of xy, and if you have a scaling of alpha p, alpha q on that, okay, then if that function is homogeneous in that, then you can write r times that function is equal to p times the partial derivative with that particular variable into x, and q times that partial derivative with respect to y, actually this one, y into y. Now coming back to the slides. Okay, now it's fine, right, sir? Then now I have a function of mass, which is a function of area and lambda. Lambda is a cosmological constant. Okay. Now, if mass scales like a length power d minus 3, d is the dimension of the space-time, and area scales like l power d minus 2, and lambda scales like 1 by l square, then by Euler's homogeneous theorem, what you can write is like d minus m minus d minus 2 dm by dA, and you can write like this. From this, dm by dA is kappa by 8 pi g, and dm by d lambda, differential of mass with the cosmologic constant, it is some term theta by 8 pi g. And what we find that this theta is nothing but a volume. It is nothing but geometrical volume. So that this term, conjugate quantity to the volume. Okay. Now you can write differential of mass as dm equal to kappa by 8 pi dA, differential of mass with the lambda d lambda. And kappa by 8 pi is nothing but the Hawking temperature. And dm by d lambda, is, I told it is something is, we are getting volume. So this lambda is a potential term for pressure. So we can define pressure as minus lambda by 8 pi. Once you define a pressure term in this, what it becomes is first law of black hole thermodynamics becomes like TdS plus omega dj phi dq plus v dp. This omega dj and phi dq comes from a charged rotating black hole. If it is not charged, then these terms will be absent. Okay. And there is some other one more relation, which is called the Smar relation. Which is similar to Euler relation in thermodynamics, which relates the internal energy to the temperature and other parameters in thermodynamics. Okay. So we have two relations, one is Smar and first law of thermodynamics. Now we have added a PV term in to the black holes. What it makes that what we identified as internal energy initially for black hole is interpreted as the enthalpy, because we have added a PV term. Okay. Now the thermodynamics of black hole in this extended phase by extension we did by adding a VTB term is found very analogous to a van der Waals fluid system. Okay. Now I have something two slides about van der Waals fluid. Historically, what is van der Waals fluid? Like historically, first experiment was done by Thomas Andrews in 1969 by studying the isotherm of carbon dioxide. And van der Waals in 1973 derived an approximate equation of state for this fluid, that is P plus A by V square into V minus B equal to T, where A takes care of the attractive character between the molecule and B non-zero size of the molecule. And small letter V is nothing but specific volume V by N. Okay, this is seen as a departure from the ideal gas behavior, ideal fluid behavior. Then critical behavior of fluid can be seen in the isotherms. Okay, and critical point is given by in the extremality condition dp by dv at equal to zero, and the second derivative of this is equal to zero. And you can obtain the critical quantities, that is pc that critical pressure, critical temperature, critical volume. And it is interesting that what we are getting as PC VC by TC ratio, it is having a universal number 3/8. So most of the fluid, this 3/8 ratio remains same. Now another feature about van der Waals fluid is, like, you can study the Gibbs free energy, and Gibbs free energy plot looks like this, where you can find that when pressure is below, I have plotted G versus D. G is the Gibbs free energy, T is the temperature. When pressure is below T, below PC, then you can see that there is a swallowtail behavior. This is called swallowtail behavior, and this is a signature of a first order phase transition.
Can you zoom into that region? Do you have that swipe pink zoom? You can pinch zoom on touchpad, no? I think.
No.
Okay, never mind.
No, it is somewhat small. I can. So this is swallowtail behavior. There is a tail coming when pressure is below critical pressure. This is a signature of a first order phase transition, and you know that there is a gas to liquid or vapor to liquid phase takes place. Okay, now going back to the reduced coordinate system, like, we can write every coordinate, thermodynamic coordinate, in a reduced coordinate system, dimensionless coordinate system. You divide it by the critical quantities. Okay, now what you will find that during the phase transition, at the critical point, the response functions, the specific heat, isothermal compressibility, and other parameters go diverges. So that is one of the characteristics. Characteristic feature observed during a phase transition or at the critical point. Now there are four numbers correspond like associated with this divergence what you observed with the response functions. Are alpha equal to 0, beta equal to half, gamma equal to 1, and delta equal to 3. Now, what kind of analogy black holes are having with van der Waals fluid? We have chosen a black hole with a global monopole sitting inside that. That theory is given by Bariola in 1989. And there is a black hole with a global monopole. So these are the details of the calculation. Now, that metric function vanishes at the horizon. And from that, you can find the mass of the black hole. From the mass, you can get Hawking temperature. And pressure, now pressure, you can identify the cosmological constant, you can identify with pressure. Then first law of thermodynamics and spar relation is written. Now entropy and volume can be obtained from the first law. Now you can rearrange the terms, and you can write equation of state. That equation of state looks exactly like van der Waals fluid, and that you can see when you plot P versus V, you can find that this diagram is very similar to the van der Waals fluid. Okay. Then you can proceed with the critical quantities and find the universal ratio. Then what you can find is that, like a liquid to gas transition in van der Waals fluid, there is a transition between a small black hole phase and to the large black hole phase. There are two phases in the black hole, and it there is a transition occurs between these phases, much like a liquid to gas transitions. Now going to the Gibbs free energy plot, again you can see that when the pressure is below critical pressure, you can see a swallowtail appearing, and this swallowtail again confirms about a first order phase transition. Now going to specific heat study, local stability is always given by a specific heat, and specific heat is plotted against entropy, and same like Gibbs free energy and PV isotherm, you can see that when pressure becomes less than PC, you will get a divergence in the specific heat. And when the pressure is more than the critical pressure, there is no divergence associated with this. So there are three regions actually. Two thermodynamically stable means, thermodynamically stable means having positive specific heat region, that is small black hole phase and large black hole phase. And there is an unstable phase, what we call as intermediate black hole phase, which is thermodynamically unstable, which appears only when it is below the critical point. And now, like usual thermodynamics, what we are having is like Maxwell's equilibrium law. There are some unphysical region in this PV isotherm. That means that with decreasing pressure, volume increases. Those kind of unphysical region, I have marked a dotted portion here between two black dots. That should be removed. That is removed by using Maxwell's construction, or it is called Maxwell's equal area law. This how much area here is balanced by how much area here. And this can
Rizwan, be... Rizwan.
Yes, sir.
So I think it seems you have 67 slides. 67 slides are needed to defend your thesis.
No,
not
sir.
Not to defend like, your synopsis.
Sir, okay? I have cut that one. Like I put every slides, but I'm not going to do everything. I will.
This is synopsis, not your defense.
I have only 50 slides. That is a technical portion I have skipped.
Okay. So you can talk about the salient points. Your publication, you have shown, and the salient points, not everything.
Okay.
So you can put everything in the PhD defense, Viva. So that's...
Okay, sir. I will wind up. I will try to.
Yeah.
Okay. So this is the what I call as coextensive diagram, which you can obtain, which tells that there are two phases, SBH and LBH. And once you cross this line, you have a first order phase transitions. Now the critical exponent associated with phase transition that you can find out, and which is matches exactly with the critical exponents we found for van der Waals fluid. Okay. Now a conclusion for these slides, like the black holes are characterized by the same critical exponents that of icing mode and water, superfluid, helium. And this is called as universality class. It means that critical or near the critical point, physical description of all the phenomena are the same. And it will not remember the microscopic description, but there is a microscopic description in there. And another takeaway point is that these critical phenomena, these features are happening in ADS black hole, which is having a consistent dual field theory description in its boundary. And why this is happening is because of this emergent gravity picture is called holographic nature of space-time. And application of this analogy. So how much time I have, sir? Hello?
Pata.
Yeah, you have taken half an hour, maybe another 10 minutes, then questions.
Okay, fine. Okay? So there are two applications for this van der Waals type analogy in black hole. One is Joule-Thomson effect and another is heat engine. But Joule-Thomson effect is nothing but you just pass a fluid from a low pressure region to high pressure region, which can lead into the cooling or heating, depends on the initial conditions. Okay. This has led to a concept of what is called enthalpy. And what is remain constant during this process is enthalpy. So these processes are called isenthalpic processes. And you can have an isenthalpic curve denoting this kind of phenomenon. And the slope of this isenthalpic curve will tell you whether you have a cooling or heating in the final state. So now coming back to the black holes, this is the left pan I have shown the van der Waals fluid and right pan I have shown the ADS black holes. And you can see similarity between these two. And similar kind of features happen in black holes. Okay, these are the effect of these parameters on the inversion and isenthalpic curves. And you can see that this Joule-Thomson coefficient increases with the parameters. And this is having like more application in cosmological perspective because this global monopole comes from the initial what you call cosmic scenarios. Now, next application is heat engine. Okay, heat engine you are having is you have a hot reservoir and a sink, and how much energy you can extract from a conversion from heat reservoir to cold reservoir, that is the heat engine. And black coal was used as a working substance for heat engine by Clifford V. Johnson in 1914. And heat engine will have certain cycles that we call it a Stirling cycle or Carnot cycle. Okay. And efficiency of the heat engine can be calculated. And we do some calculation on regular black holes. Regular black holes are the one which do not possess singularities at the coordinate r equal to zero at the center. Okay. This was derived by Bardeen in 1968. And we consider a quintessence field surrounding to the black hole. And that metric function reads like this. Now going back to the thermodynamics, you can see the PV isotherms and the effect of these parameters on the PV isotherms. Now calculating the efficiency of this heat engine where regular black hole is used as a working substance, you can see that efficiency gets increased by the black hole parameters. So if you are using black hole as a working substance, your efficiency is more. Okay. Now, I have told this provides another novel mechanism to extract energy from black holes via, in addition to Penrose process, you have some way of extracting energy from black holes. And this is having a very good interpretation in ADS-CFT correspondence. And this having a huge implication in this what is called this holographic scenario. Now going back to the thermodynamic geometry case, and you will find that black hole thermodynamics would appear very much in need of some microscopic foundations. And even though it is a domain of quantum gravity theories, but from the Boltzmann argument, you know that if something is hot, it must have microstructure. So without invoking any quantum gravity theory, one can tell something about this microstructure. So we call it atoms of space-time. So it is not odd to speculate some what kind of interaction in micromolecule using the observed thermodynamics of black hole. The Rupiner, George Rupiner in 2008, based on the theory of fluctuations, proposed that there is a phenomenological model for black hole microstructure. What is the theory of fluctuation? That even though physical quantities are almost in equilibrium, almost near to mean value, but there is a deviation. They fluctuate even in the equilibrium states. So this kind of a fluctuation, probability of finding some state between x and x naught plus dx is given by microcanonical ensemble. And using the Boltzmann's entropy formula, you can write s equal to kb ln omega, and you can invert this one. This was a starting point for Einstein to do theory of fluctuations. And substituting back, you can obtain probability of this thing. You can understand that this is a Gaussian distribution you will get. Now, Taylor expansion of this entropy around equilibrium value, and the system will evolve in such a manner that it will have a maximum entropy value, and denoting, so this first derivative vanishes. And other terms, x minus x to the deviation with the mean value, I will denote as delta x. And the kb by the second term, I denote it as variance. We can see that probability distribution is a Gaussian. And in canonical ensemble, when you allow energy to fluctuate, what it makes is this variance will give you variance will give you a specific heat CV. So whatever variable you are fluctuating, according corresponding to that, you will get a response functions. So if energy is fluctuating, it will leads to a specific heat. And statistical mechanics provides the profound result that these response functions are exactly given by the mean square fluctuations or respective conjugate thermodynamic properties of system. Now, rewriting the previous equation, what you will find is the second derivative of the entropy with respect to thermodynamic variable that you can write in terms of a metric tensor. That means a distance between the thermodynamic state is of the form a second rank metric tensor G mu. And the distance between two fluctuating states is inversely proportional to the probability of fluctuation between these states. So the metric tensor, which is nothing more than a response function, speaks about thermodynamic stability. And this metric, which is the Hessian of entropy, consists of response function like heat capacity and compressibility. Now, this approach is used, approached by using differential geometry is popularly known as thermodynamic geometry. It is the work of Weinhold and Rupiner, which brought the attention to this field. And moving forward with metric tensor, you can using normal Riemannian geometry, you can calculate many other things like curvature scalars. So Rupiner, George Rupiner conjectured that this curvature scalar captures the essential details about microscopic or mesoscopic interaction. So if the this curvature scalar is negative, which tells that there is attractive interaction in the microstructure, and if r equal to zero means it is non-interacting or a very weak interactions. If this curvature is more than zero, then there is a repulsive interaction. And the phase transition of the system can be seen in the divergence of the curvature scalar. And this kind of a method is applied to various statistical models like van der Waals fluid and different models, including magnetic models. And now applying this thing to black hole, and you have obtained like equation of state for black hole state. And you have two states now, stable state, a small black hole phase and larger black hole phase. And you can plot R versus scalar versus volume, where you will find that when it is near to the critical point, there will be a divergence in the R. And when it is above the critical point, there is no divergence as such. Okay. Now plotting this thing in R versus T plane, you can see that two different, this blue line corresponding to SBH phase and this red line corresponding to LPH phase, and SBH phase is having some positive value, and LBH value, LBH is always has a negative R, that tells that that LBH has a attractive interaction and LBH having a repulsive interactions. Now finding the critical exponent corresponding to this, you will find that this is having a critical exponent of half. Now conclusions and future direction. In our work, we have studied the thermodynamics and application in different radius black hole. And it is found that it is analogous to van der Waals system, and there is a liquid gas kind of a transition happening in black holes, and Joule-Thomson effect and heat engine is constructed out of black holes, and the microstructure of a black hole is probed through Rupiner geometry. And how you can interpret, one way to interpret this as that there is an effective fluid description for black holes. One way to interpret is this. Another thing is these are the manifestations of emergent gravity paradigm, where fundamentally gravity emerges from some condensed matter system. Or like what you can call is atoms of space-time, this idea of gravity, having underlying microstructure similar to thermodynamic or hydrodynamic system. And the work like ours, we feel that the work like ours will possibly shed some light on microscopic structure of many strange phenomena, including condensed matter system, and it will establish some link between black hole physics and problem of statistical mechanics of many body systems. Thank you.
Thank you, everyone. Okay. I'll stop the recording so
okay.
Questions can begin, okay? Good job.